But you're gonna need a few things. Straight back chair, sturdy, one without arms, pair of light hand weights, a tennis ball we use for stretching our hands and feet, and a large ball for balance. Have some water close by. It's always a good thing when you're exercising. We're gonna start in a seated position, and then we'll stand and we'll come back to the chair for cool down. So make sure everything is underneath your chair. So close to everyone. And your feet wide, placed on the floor, good posture in the chair. Take a deep breath through the nose. Hold it and let it out slowly through the mouth. Again. And let it out. Drop your head forward as you press your shoulders down, stretching the neck. And then lift the head back to a neutral position and tilt it to the side. You're listening. And then to the other side. And center. This time look up. The jaw relaxes. Your mouth opens. And again, chin to the chest. Sit tall and circle the head. You don't want to hit those forward positions. Both directions. And again, forward and up. And back to neutral. Turn just the head to look to one side. Perfect. And to the other side. Side to side. And again to the front. Up and down. Sitting tall. And that neutral position. The shoulders, roll them. It's gonna be a hot few days.
Aww.
Yeah. Change the direction. Good. Then here, the arms are out, shoulders relax, move the fingers. You love it, don't you? Bob, do you have enough room for the easel? Okay, stretch those fingers out and tap the index finger a few times to the thumb and then the next finger and the next finger. Yeah. Then we're back to stretching that. Scratch.
Two, three, four. Five.
The shoulders relax, those fingers extend.
One, two, three, four, five.
Change it up.
Five, four, three, two, one.
And some small circles. Please don't hit that easel. Change the direction and big. Circle. Good. Change direction and a bigger circle. Thank you, my dear. Reverse that big circle. Up. Keep on stretched overhead, reaching for the ceiling. It's
one and two.
If you're
and
home, count
three
with us.
And four.
Looking
and
up.
Five.
And the arms down to the side. Flexed hand, bring it to the shoulder.
One, two, three, four, five.
They come down, they rest on the chair, looking forward, bend for a side stretch. Yeah. And then same thing on the side, up and over. Good. And now cross the arms over the chest, the hands placed on your shoulders, twisting the upper body, working that spine and hold. And to the other side. And again, face forward as you place the hands on the chair, feet wide. So shoulders, hips, knees, feet pretty much in line. And you're going to shift the weight to one side and lift the opposite
one,
hip up.
And two, and three, and four, and five.
Great job.
And
back to this position for a walk in place. So the knees are lifted, the arms are moving just a little bit, and you should have maybe this much room behind you. So hopefully you're not you're not leaning against the back of the chair. She was showing what not to do.
I was checking.
That's oh, okay, there you go, checking. And back to this position. So, checking to see if you have enough room. You should be able to keep your feet on the floor and lean back and not touch the back of the chair. If you say you cannot, then come forward a little bit. We're gonna reach down and grab the weights. We're gonna start with a bicep curl. The fingers are wrapped and the elbows tucked. Find something in front of you to look at. So you lift that chin up a little bit and we're gonna bring these to the shoulder.
One.
And back down.
Two.
Got it.
Three. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
That's the first set of 10 reps, so stretch out a little bit. Take a deeper breath, maybe. Again, focus as you tuck the elbows, lift and curl.
One, two, three, four, five. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
And then they come down. We're going to take the weights to the outside of the chair legs. Yeah, that's why we don't want arms on the chairs. So rotate the shoulders and the arms forward. And then rotate back, pinching the shoulder blades together, stretching the chest. Good. And then back to that neutral position. One up. The elbow tucked and a side stretch. Good. Good. I'm gonna stack your chair next time and then lift it up. Oh, yeah, stretch it up. Great job. And then here, we're gonna keep one. With the other one, if you would put it underneath the chair so it's out of the way. And we're gonna hold this with both hands, sitting tall. For an overhead extension, the arms are fairly straight. They're not locked at the elbow, but they're straight arms. The shoulders press down, and the weight now drops to the back. And
one.
It's up for 10.
One, two, three.
Good.
Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10.
Okay, wrap up, stretch overhead, the shoulders relax, the weight drops to the back, and it's up.
One, two, three, four.
Nice and loud,
five,
I like that.
Six,
seven,
eight, nine,
and
ten.
Perfect, let's put that one on the floor underneath the chair as well. And in this position, we go to a closed position, feet together and the knees together. Maybe a little adjustment in the chair. Still a lot of room back there. Arms crossed, looking forward. The legs straight out and the feet off the floor. It's flex and point.
Two, three, four,
good.
Five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten. Toes up, the heels glued together and the
one,
toes are out.
Two, three, four, five.
Reverse it, one.
Two, three, four, five.
They come down, they uncross and separate back into a starting position with one out and the arms out and the fingers spread apart. You'll hear me say open hand. This is an open hand. So we're gonna sit up and then twist upper body, reaching for the foot with the opposite hand. Look down at your foot as you reach with the other arm for the ceiling. Good, and then come up. Change, same arm as leg, reach for it, good, but look down, there you go, perfect. And the arms drop and that leg comes in, the other one's stretched out, opposite arm to leg, reach and hold, two, three,
four,
five. You got it, same arm as leg, reach and hold,
one, two, three, four, five.
Good job. And they come back down to this position. One here, open hand again. It's going to reach across the chest and up. Follow the hand as it reaches for the ceiling, stretching out of the rib cage, but you stay on the chair. Try it on the other side. Good. Reach for it. Nice. And now, across, parallel to the floor. Follow your hand. Reach up. And then diagonally down, outside of the opposite foot with the fingers spread apart. Perfect. And then there. Shoot that arrow across. And this side. And stretch it. Down and grab the weights again, and we're going to do some seated row. Yes. Okay. Soft but firm grip. The arms, they're dropped to the side, and your shoulders are in line with your hips. It's a flat back. We're going to transfer a little weight forward, not looking at me, but down at the floor as you raise these up, down.
Two, three, four. Five.
I like it when you're here.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine. And that's it.
Ten.
Take a break. Good job. I know it's not a long break, but a break nonetheless. Shake it out. The dropped again. Forward with a flat back, looking down at the floor, lift and up.
One.
One.
Two.
Two. Good.
Three.
Four.
Five,
six,
seven,
eight, nine, ten,
and down.
Great. Yeah, same. And on the floor, underneath that chair, your feet still in that position, put your fingers together and shift the weight to one side as you lift the other one up. Hands go below the knee for a good stretch. Bring it up as high as you can. And then here, shift the weight a little and lift this one up. And back into this position where our arms drop and focus on something in front of you, looking way down at the other side of the thermostat. So we're going to lift a knee, it's a flexed foot, and then extend that leg and point it. One,
two,
beautiful.
Three,
four,
five,
you got it.
Six,
seven.
Eight, nine, ten.
And down it shifts just a little, and the other one is up, flex and point.
One, two, three, four,
five,
six,
seven. We're almost there.
Eight, nine, ten.
Great job. And back into this position where I know we scoop forward and back just a little bit. It's forward now, so come out just a little bit more, taking a little bit more of that leg off the seat and extend. One. Going to slide the hands down, but you want to sit tall. You're going to reach from the hip. The focus again is on that foot that's out there. Go down and then drop the head. Breathe into the stretch. And then come up slowly. Perfect. Again, up and over. Leg, it comes in, keep them wide, and then this one, sitting tall as you slide those hands down, breathing into the stretch, drop the head, come up, perfect, and again, stretch it out. In a little wider position. We're already out toward the edge before that leg off the seat, so open it up. Working to stretch that hip area and that inner thigh, so everyone's a little different, of course, and some are real flexible, others are not. So what you do want to be aware of is keeping your knees in line with your feet, nice straight spine, and the arms, they're out. I'm going to place a hand on the inside to support this and gently push it back. Straight up with the other one. open hand again as you twist. Now look up at that in the air. Those fingers stretching, and the other is going on the inside of the calf, traveling down towards your ankle, maybe even touching the floor. And then come up. Beautiful job. And then to the other side, stretch it. Both arms to the side and down as you walk the feet. Heel, toe. We're in a closed position. Knees touching if you can and the arms crossed. Straight back. Transferring a little weight forward. Look about 2 feet beyond your toes. And then push on the outside of your feet, opening the knees. You should feel this in your hip. Together again and up. Good. And then forward. And then we uncross them. I'm gonna turn to the side, and this one's for you, Charlie in Indiana. So your feet are apart, you've got that chair leg in between your feet, the hand close to the back of the chair holds the frame as the outside leg extends, hip to toe, and the arms reaching forward from shoulder to fingertips with the fingers spread apart. Bring it in and round the back. Tucking the chin to the chest. Again, stretch it out and curl it up. Beautiful. And come up. Two to the other side. Make sure that you start with your feet, chair leg in between them, inside hand holding, and reach forward. As far as you can. You're holding on, so stretch and then curl it up.
Valerie, you're so funny.
She's setting her watch while she does this.
I'm just sending a text.
Okay, we're back into this position. Our feet right in line with our shoulders and our hips. We're going to do something that doesn't require any weights. It's called a chair lift. You can use your own body weight. So a chair with your hands braced on it. A little forward with that weight, looking down. You're gonna lift this off the seat just a little bit, 10 times. It's up,
one,
down,
two, three,
good,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine, ten. And down, feet together, and the knees together. Out a little bit, still holding on, still sitting tall as you lean back. The knees come to the chest and down. It's up.
One, two,
three,
four,
five. Lift them
six,
high.
Seven,
eight, you got it.
Nine, ten.
And down. And we're going to extend them, crossing one over the other, taking a lot of that leg off of the seat. We're going to do some toe touches. So the arms out, hands together. You've got options. You can reach forward and down, or you can reach up and over, and that's what we're going to do. So it's up, so it's one, reaching up and over,
two,
good,
three,
four, give it one more shot,
five,
perfect, and then place the other one on top. Make sure you're sitting tall, reach for it,
one.
Breathing.
Two. Three.
I like what I see.
Four.
Five. And good. And back into a starting position, a little maybe deeper into the chair. Arms out, just in line with your shoulders. We're going to do the same thing, but in the air, alternating right, left. Toe touches.
One.
And
two.
Get excited.
And three.
And four,
and five,
and
six,
and
seven,
and
eight,
and
nine,
and
ten, and
great job. Don't wait for me to remind you about water. If you're thirsty, have some. We'll just move right along. So our feet apart, our arms again out in line with the shoulders, sitting tall. We're just going to drop them. And then flex. It's okay. Three, four, five. Make a fingers out and now the arms crossed. Palms are together and the fingers locked. Extend the arms, working within your range. Don't force it, but if you can pull them back out of sight, that's great. Lower them down, but don't drop the chin. Sit tall, stretch it. Down, and this last one, we're gonna stop halfway, placing the other one on top, lock it in. And I'm always tighter with this left arm on top. Good, and then three. Down and separate them, kind of shake them out a little bit. Ah. Straight arm, doesn't bend. So it doesn't go very far, not like that, without bending it. And then this other hand is placed just above the elbow, and we're gonna push it back gently. Good, so it's a straight arm. And try the other one. Straight out, go slightly to the side, place it above the elbow, move it back. Good job. Shake it out. An open hand. And the elbows bent and lifted a bit. We're going to bring those to the front, the forearms touching the fingers together. And then stretch it, bring it together. Good. And stretch it, and together. Two more. Push back. There. Last one. Close the book. Right, shake them out. Sitting tall, one arm out, palms up. The other hand goes underneath it and grabs the fingers, gently pulling them, stretching that hand. Yeah, good job. Fingers up, pull them back. Good. And then the other one. Flipped and stretched. Fingers up, pull them back. Posture, arms are out, those fingers spread apart. Close and open. Two,
three, four, five, six.
Stretch it.
Seven, eight, nine, ten.
Now bring it in like a little claw. Make a face with it. Then make a fist and then drop and stretch and lift it up and open slowly. Shake them out. Again, here, we're just gonna rotate the arms, the shoulders, and the hands. Just soft hands, okay? Now, make one up and the other down. Yeah. So it's not this, but it's just, yeah, flip it. Okay. All right, shake them out. Gosh, they're heavy today. All right, bring them together, yeah, and then open. So what does it look like? That, yeah. Open, and open, open, and there. All right, we're good. Mat flying around. We're gonna grab the weights again. That was a little diversion from these heavy things. So we're gonna put them on our legs, working lower body. So they're out to the very edge, the open hand resting on top. And sitting tall, we're gonna lift one, extend it out, bend it, and place it down nice and wide, shifting the weight to the other side. It's up, out, in, down.
Two, out, in, down. Up, out, in, down. Three, out, in, down. Up, out, in, down.
Four,
out, in, down. Up, out, in,
down. Last one.
Five, out, in,
down,
it's up, out, in, down.
Straight leg, out. Looking, it's easy to go like this, but try to sit tall, looking forward, straight leg lift 10 times. It's up.
One, two, three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
now flex foot.
One, two, three, four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten.
It's back into place. The other one, stretch it out. Sitting more forward than back. You almost feel like you're probably way out here, but shoulders over hips. Ready?
One, two,
good.
Three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
and flex toes up.
One,
two,
three,
four,
five,
six,
manageable, so making sure that they're out of your way, put them underneath the chair. And remember the tennis ball that I said stuck in my chair? There we go. We use this almost for every class. So if you don't have a tennis ball, maybe go get some or use some socks, roll them up into a ball. But sit tall. Now we're going to warm up our hands and feet. Just rolling it between our hands. And if you have a quick second, take your shoes off and socks or bare feet. It's felt better when we get to the foot. So fingers apart, take it and stretch. Both hands. Good posture as you sit here and work that. Good. Your balance begins bottom of your feet. Yeah. So we're going to sit tall in the chair and make a little place for this little fist, soft, extending the arm. Working to challenge your balance. Maybe you want to close your eyes and do a pattern, maybe a circle or just extending the arm forward and back, whatever you want to do, but try to keep it there. Maybe your eyes are closed. And then carefully transfer it to the other hand, another soft fist. I'm going to draw a huge circle. Pendulum back and forth. Both out and very close to each other as you transfer it from right to left. Good. Open your eyes. Y'all better have been doing that, were you? All right, on the floor, a foot resting on top, push down on it. Everyone has their shoes and socks up. Cool. So, push down and roll your foot back and forth, stimulating the bottom of your feet with all the nerves on it. Both sides. That doesn't happen very often. Yeah. Summer. All right. Before it rolls away, reach down and grab it. We're in class. It fits pretty snugly between the seat and the back. So and we're going to come back into the chair using the back this time. And it feels good to lean against it. Make sure you're all the way in where the back meets the seat and your feet still wide, but back slightly behind your knees. Hands are on your hips. That usually happens to me. And you want to press into the back of the chair and then arch the back. Good. And then press into it. Pull away, and the last time, keep pressing. Looking forward, both legs out and up. Circle one,
two, three, four,
five. The other way.
Five, four, three, two, one.
And they hit the floor. They're still wide, they get pulled back and away from the chair. This is a challenge sometimes. You want to shift your weight to one side. The opposite hip is lifted as you kind of scooch forward, walk forward, yeah, to the very edge, and you should have a lot of room back there, and the arms out, shoulders relaxed, palms up, all about the abdominals right now. We're going to lean back and hold, and come up. We're going to extend them overhead, shoulders relaxed, lean back and hold, so you can keep your feet on the floor, and up. The arms to the side, open the chest, and lean back, and come up, and forward, and lean back. I touched, you're not supposed to, it was an accident. Cross your arms and lean back, and hold.
Minus two to the mirror.
And come up, sitting tall, those hands again resting on your thighs, it's a flat back. You're going to reach from the hip. Looking down at this pretty floor. And then lift one heel, then the other. Drop the first and the second. It's up, up, down, down. Three.
Up, down, down. Four. Up, down.
One more.
Down.
Five.
Up.
Just
down,
the heels
down.
A few times. Up and down.
Two.
Last one.
Three.
What is this position called?
Nose over toes.
Nose over toes, absolutely. It's a sit to stand position, so make sure your feet are apart and all of this is forward as you shift to the ball of the foot. We're going to come out of the chair. Bend the knees, the weight is in the heel, and it's halfway there when you hit the chair. The other part is back to a starting position. So forward and up, bend back down, perfect. And three, two more, good. Four, guys are too good. Happy Monday. And up and back into it. Shoulders over hips, yeah. Spread the fingers, it's that open hand. We're gonna place them on the neck and the elbows, stretch the chest. Twist to one side and then to the other. It's a warm up for a seated crunch. And as you twist, this time lift the knee to the opposite elbow.
One.
And good.
Two.
Shout it out.
Three.
And.
Four.
Four.
And.
Five.
And.
Six.
Six.
And.
Seven.
And.
Eight.
And.
Nine.
Good.
And.
Ten.
And.
Perfect. Whew. Take a deep breath. All right. The big ball. We need it. Again, you're sitting toward the front with your feet flat on the floor and the ball, you know, 11 inches, I guess, and soft but firm. So one that a child would play with. Sitting tall, we're gonna hold it with the palm of the hand and the ball touches the chest, the elbows are down. Stretch them out. Focus on the ball or the rim, just the top of it. As you reach forward, transferring your weight over your thighs, over your knees, and over the floor, and just hold it there. Perfect. Place your head in between the arms and hold it there. Lift the head, slowly coming to that upright position, arms still stretching forward. Pull away from the spine, tucking the chin to the chest, the arms still reaching forward. And then sit real tall. Your arms overhead. Lean back a little, keep your feet glued to the floor, and come up. Again, it's that starting position. Track the ball as you twist the upper body to the side as far as you can go. Hold. Two,
three,
four, five. Perfect. Other side. Track it, twisting, and hold.
Two, three,
four, five.
And again, here, and put it on the chest. The elbows dropped and squeeze. Yes, I had to blow all of those up.
It doesn't look like it's gonna pop.
Not this one, and relax. I know, one more time, squeeze. But it goes in a little.
Big deal.
That's true. And relax. That space, fill it up. Yeah, and it works best when you're forward in the chair. Otherwise, your option is on the knee. And the exercise is placing the ball on the inner thigh, the hands on top, and the feet touching. Tall in the chair, and then squeeze it. Beautiful. Match. Kind of quivering, shaky? Okay, relax. One more time, squeeze. Good. And relax. Yeah, very nice. Hold the ball and separate the feet. We're going to put this on the floor, and I'm going to scoot in a couple of inches, taking the ball to one side. It's still pretty close to the front of the chair, but just to the side, and this foot's going to sit very softly on top. The arms overhead, and if you feel like you're going to not do well with your balance, then put them down here. Use the chair. But arms up. That other leg is straight out, and we're going to lift it up and just hold
one,
it.
One, two,
yeah, we're just going to hold it.
Four, five.
Good, and back down. Now flex it, toes up, lift it up and hold.
One, two,
three,
four,
Five. Great job. Let's try the other side. And sure, you can make this harder. You could wear ankle weights. You could not be sitting on a chair. Maybe you're sitting on a stability ball. Yeah, or not. There's always ways to challenge your balance. So again, don't put a lot of weight on it. Arms overhead. Focus as you lift and hold.
2, 3, 4, 5.
Great job. And flex it. Lift it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Great job. And there. All right. We're going to get out of the chair. And I'm going to put this away. You can put it underneath or on the seat, but we're done with it. So our feet are wide. Our weight shifts as you come up. Standing to the back of the chair, fingers on the back if you need it. Feet wide. If you don't, the arms are dropped. And the focus is always forward as we do some heel lifts. Up, down.
2, 3,
good.
4, 5, 6, 7.
We're gonna hold on 10.
8, 9.
Go up, get your balance.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
And flat. Using the chair if you need it, I do. The weight now shifts to the heel. Don't stick this out, but lift the toes up. It's
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Keep going.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
And now we're going to do some leg lifts, starting with that lateral leg lift. So make sure that you're not reaching for the chair. You're close enough that the hands could just be. The weight is on one straight leg. It's a soft knee. And this one's going to go out to the side, not very high. Toes, hips, and knees facing forward. So it's 1. Good.
2.
Feel this in your
3.
Head.
4.
5. Good.
6.
7. What happened to the smiles?
8, 9, 10.
Placing it wide, shifting the weight, and it's the other side. Up
1,
and down.
2.
Good.
3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Back to start. Valerie, I think it's okay. Okay. We'll be standing to the back for some leg lifts. Straight leg. So you've gone from this position, shifting the weight to one standing leg. Straight leg lifts, up for 10.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
you got it.
7, 8, 9, 10.
Bend the standing knee and that heel presses into the floor. You can never be too loud. All right, come up, bring it forward, the weight will shift. This is a straight leg, it's up,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Bend and sit into it. Perfect. And we're back to a starting position. Don't kick anyone or anything behind you. Alternating right, left kicks.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Well, we've done side, we've done back, and now we have to do the front. So to the side of the chair, a little space between, body's in line with the frame, but the weight on the inside, hold it, or just place your hands, straight leg out, focus, forward. It's up,
1, down. 2, 3, 4, 5.
We love it.
6, 7, 8.
Get ready.
9, 10.
Bend the knee and lift it
1, up, down.
2, 3, 4, 5. Good.
6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
And there. Other side. All right. We're in a good position. position for balance, we just shift some of that weight to the inside leg, hand here, slide it forward, focus, and it's
one, two, three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten.
Bend and lift.
One, two, three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten.
Have some water while I turn this down. We're going to do some balance exercises. Standing to the side of the chair, we're going to practice some different positions. So your body's just in line with the frame, but the inside leg bears most of the weight. The hand is here if you need it. A split step is taking a step forward with the outside foot, just a normal step, and they're staggered. Your weight, though, right in the middle. Yeah. How do you know that? Because you can raise your heels off the floor. Good. Use the chair if you need it. If you don't, standing still and arms out and out. Good. Bring it in and bring it down. Placing the hand on the chair as you slide this over in line, but maybe 12 inches between those feet. I can put at least my open hand in between the heel and the toe so they're not touching, but they're in line. The weight again placed right in the middle, hand on the chair, we're both out, focus, and stretch, great job, and down, hand on the chair, the weight transfers back into that inside leg, bring this back, so we're touching now, heel toe, I only see, you only have one foot. Yeah, I should only see that one foot in front. Keep your hand on the chair, but extend the outside arm. Again, you should be able to pop your heels up. You're still in the middle. Good. And just... and down. We've got the other side to do, so come on over. In this position, right underneath us. Arms out. Soft knees, straight legs, and then open. And down. Transfer it to the inside leg, hand on the chair, take a split step forward. Now the weight should be in the middle because Valerie can raise her heels up and down. Perfect. All right. Okay. Keep it there if you need it. If you don't, extend one. Feet flat on the floor as you stretch those arms to the side. Good. Bring it in and bring it down. Hold on to the chair as you slide this over. A lot of room between both feet, but they're in line. Perfect. All right. There. It's a challenge. And sometimes, you know, your balance is great and others not so. So it just depends. And boy, does medication play a big deal. Allergies too. Or in my case, lack of sleep. So we're gonna bring that front foot back. It's gonna touch heel and toe. The weight though in the center, hand on the chair, outside arm. It's a good thing to safe place, and then down. Awesome. Everything we've used today would be the balls and the weights. Make sure that they're either on top or underneath. We can do a little cardio. So keep in motion. You can sit, but keep in motion.
Bye.
Have a little sip of water. And we're back to the chair. Back to sitting forward in the chair. And cool down. It's on its way. It looks very much like warm up. So, but before that, grab your favorite weight. Is that it? Okay. Wrap both hands around it. Sitting tall, those arms stretched, and it's reaching forward, flat back. Drop it all the way up.
Two.
Up.
Three.
Up.
Four.
Up.
Five.
Up.
Six.
We're almost there.
Up.
Seven.
Up.
Eight.
Up.
Nine.
Up.
No second set.
Ten.
Up.
Great job. All right. On the floor. And
sunset's blue music
and down
in soul.
Circle slowly.
Yeah.